and do life here right now, something goes with the same. He was describing what? He's describing the waves, right? And the bubbling, right? The bubbles, whatever he hears, right? And after that, he compared it with Sophocles about whatever he said, like Sophocles himself hear what he hears. So what did you hear?
Because he mentioned that because the world now it is became weak because no face or no religion.
No, I'm not talking about him. Just forget Mr. Arnold and Matthew and so forth this way now. Just put them on the side. What did you learn from them? Did you hear the secret force?
Your own being. Your own being and your own understanding.
Just forget about them. Anything you read, a poem, a topic somewhere, a situation here, you have to have your own opinion about it. If you don't have your own opinion about it, this means you didn't learn anything, you are not supposed to be here.
No, I learned something else, give us your opinion. Huh? This is the first attempt to allow me.
I'm just trying to take you out here. So I'm trying to tell you, like you say, like I'm asking you right now, did you listen to the CD before? Did you go to Comfoda before? Comfoda. Right, it's in here, right? It's around this area. Did you go to the beach before?
Yes.
Right. And you learned that poem before, right?
Yes.
So when you went up there, did you hear the sea?
The sea and the waves, which...
Oh, right. That's what I'm trying to tell you. You hear something, you learn something, and you have to apply it. Not like you're not going to be like them, right? I know it's a gift, but at least you say your opinion about it. Say, oh, he talk about your police, talk about yourself. I went to Comfoda before, I hear that before. I'm really not with Arnold or what's up with police. I'm here in Comfoda. That's how it goes.
Yes. Thank you.
You're welcome, sir.
Yes, friends, we are not coming. We have questions. Discussions are very important, okay, for a presentation. This is Muhammad Yangin. Rashad.
Please, please, please. So, I'd like to have a personal comment.
Please, please, please.
I'm a very good presenter. Shouldn't give any impression about it when you ask a question for the audience or the students or the people who watch. When you ask a question that there is no answer, that you give a smile that is have an inverted impression when you present something. That is, you ask someone, and I didn't listen carefully, and I don't care about listening now, but I write down some words here. That is, when you ask that anyone understand anything of this poem, and no one answered, and you gave as a smile, you know? It may reflect a very bad impression about the person. Do you know? You should consider this.
Okay. So much.
Well, somewhere. That's another one.
I mean, in
just yes.
To support him.
I'm supporting him.
I know, but I need to feel that
he is from. He is really good.
Yeah.
He is really good, and his pronunciation is good. But there's another point about. The poem. You already let us hear from the computer, right? From the table, so the CD or flash or whatever. Why you didn't say it yourself? Because like when you say, as there is a way, when you present a poem, there is a way. Always intonation and stops, right? And there is a way when you present prose. So this is my question, why you didn't say it yourself? You already heard it before, right?
I prefer to add this process.
I didn't get first.
Different English is pure.
No.
He is afraid of making mistakes in pronunciation.
If you don't make mistakes, you will never go forward.
I told him that.
You will not go forward.
We listen.
We are not perfect. No one is perfect. If I'm going to go on and speak right now, I'm going to make mistakes. That doesn't mean like everyone here is perfect. No one is perfect. The one is perfect come here and tell me he is perfect. I'm not perfect. The doctor is not perfect. No one is perfect. So you hear it. This is a way of listening to poetry. You hear it and you listen to it. You see how he himself stops and get the intonation and get it and make you in the poem. This is how I'm going to present after that. Because like when you're going to, inshallah, you're going to make your own poem. So there is a way of making people look at you. The poem is not a prose, even the prose, right, itself is something you make the people get and interact with, you understand what you're talking about. This is the meaning of someone talking about something and someone just saying something else. This is another poem. Like, I thought you're going to present the poem yourself. You are good. That's good. This is person. This is very good. But
this is part of the syllabus, part of the meaning that the student who study poetry should be avoided.
Should be?
No, I don't.
No.
It's that because you study, you can say poetry that you're supposed to be avoided. It's not important. This is not the point.
This is not my. But what is your opinion in two lines? And I didn't ask you to write a poem from 20 lines or 4 or 5 stanzas. No.
One line, 2 lines.
2 lines, go with the rest. This is my own way. That's it. I'm not a poem.
The first thing that you urged is very nice, and it reminds me with a very important idea we need to understand. In the previous presentation last year, Mr. Abdul, who was one of the lecturers of the faculty year or so, but now I don't know in which department, in which college he is now, he told us a very beautiful idea. And I told my friends that, okay, answering on the question, it is mixed with what you asked, Brother Muhammad, with the question of our friend also, the literary courses. All the different courses and other courses of the department. In my media, it is organized, they are organized, not to make students, poets, or dramatists, or novelists, or whatever, just to help them, okay, as he said, in one good glance, increasing, enlarging the background of English. So this is the main purpose, okay, we deal with poetry. We deal with novels, we deal with drama and prose criticism in order to enlarge our background of English, in order to get something and to reflect this something as a language for understanding among people. This is the main idea. But also, it is beautiful. Beautiful to get something to enjoy it for people. And people are different in their natures, in their personalities, in their behavior, in their feelings. Okay. Yes, I like drama most. I hate poetry because I find it difficult. Some others, the opposite. They like poetry the most because they feel the feeling, the emotions, as Wordsworth said, that overflow of emotions and spontaneous feelings, like that. This is the idea. Getting the language is the best thing. Then, what can we get of extra ideas? It can be fine. The idea which I want to focus, what it is about to say, is that if you need to learn language, live the language. You need to learn language, live the language. It means go deeper inside it and be mixed with it, understand everything. One of the ideas I told my boys, my friends, my students, don't read, understand, and try to express from your mind. After understanding. So this is the idea. You can discuss, you can negotiate. Even if your idea is opposite from the others, it can be correct. But just tell us your ideas. We are understanding. Okay?
Okay, so for our friends,
okay, again, as I said, it is a good try for them. I think that before they didn't try such presentations, they were not put in a situation to stand and to speak, and it was very difficult for the people. Now they are facing the difficulty. But with this difficulty, time by time, step by step, try by another, they will overcome, you will master. Okay? Your ideas are perfect. When you read the poem, read it. Or after reading it by its original native speaker, okay, we need to do personal comments. Your understanding reflects it. In English, we said something like criticism. What is criticism? I asked about this one, a table. What is table? People, no, it is not a table. For myself, I give my opinion that it is the symbol of knowledge. I can defend it. I can defend my idea. This is not a desk, this is not a table. It is a symbol of knowledge. So how can I defend it? My understanding. It goes by that. Okay? You put some very beautiful and crucial ideas for our students to understand it. And over the keynote, but maybe from less. Or the situation is not giving them time to make one presentation, second presentation, and maybe they didn't watch or the view or participate in nice presentations before to compare and to put themselves in another one like that. This is my ideas concerning his doing. Dr. Muhammad, any ideas? Is it satisfactory?
Yes.
Any other ideas, friends? Any other questions? Any other remarks? So it is not a presentation that just to say, hey, turn the room and finish. Those remarks we get from them. We learn from them. We understand from them. Preparation.
Yes, just again, it reminds me of something. And some of the students, they ask me, why we have to study literature? Why we have to teach literature? This is the question sometimes they face in some classes. Because we are in the field of translation. So why don't we ask them to bother about something let's say like a play or a novel, but we are going to learn from this? Actually, we have an answer for this question. For my student, I ask them, what does mean literature? Literature not just mean to read a Bible or to read a novel and that's it's finished. No. Sometimes the Bible or the novelist will teach us something from his experience. He cannot write a Bible just out of a vacuum or from nothing. He has an experience, he has something, he has a lesson, he wants to share his feeling and experience with us. So don't forget just saying, yeah, we are going to enrich our vocabulary, we are going to enrich our language, but this is one of the part. But the second part also, don't forget the value. And someone who will say that, what we are going to learn from the worst thing culture. No, if you have something negative, make it positive by your explanation, and you have to compare that word between what we have and what they're having. So I think not literature just to enrich your vocabulary, teach you language, but the values and the culture. Sometimes you have to expose those in the foreign countries. You are going to know something about the culture, you are going to get something about the values. At the same time, you have to compare your supreme values and important values to each other. So literature is by itself. Don't try to underestimate literature. Because some people actually they say literature is nothing. Literature is just any stories and trivialities. No, it is not like this. Just because I'm in the literature. No. Just really, we are going to learn something from literature. The values and the qualities. And we are going to just, as he talks to you, I'm teaching about, really you have to criticize. You have to get this critical thinking, not just to read what are thinking. This is the most important point. Sometimes as I ask you the exam, you are going to explain something correct below the paper, okay, so at the end of the paper. And at the beginning you have answered wrong because you just memorize. If you start to focus on what you are going to study, you are going to answer well. So literature, it is life itself, not just aiming to learn English, to learn your life, to learn your experiences of some people there. This man, Matthew Arnold, when he started to write his Bible, do you think just he has to get a band and he has, no, he has experience. He has suffering. He has this good, I can say, lesson he wants to share with us. So, please don't underestimate the literature or to make it just closed to such to learn or teach you a kind of words. No, literature, again, I have to confirm it is life itself is going to learn us things. Thanks.
Thank you so much. Thank you for all. And yes, they are going in the same circle, in the same unit, for the same purpose. Okay. Even if they are in
the same place. Once you try, always, once you try, it will be all right. I'm not talking about even poetry. Our teaching sometimes in a lot of places, in schools and universities, colleges, they never ask you what is your opinion. But is this what you need? No. What they need your opinion, because you are the one who's going to lead after them. So what's your opinion? Look like in a movement. They give like maybe an election like that for kids. They give them like a charcoal and just a flame. A piece of a charcoal and a flame. C plus O going to be CO2. For us, we learn it that way. But they don't do it that way. They give you a piece of a charcoal and a flame and they leave you. Why?